let's talk about batch apex. So whenever you want to execute a particular code onto like many records, like literally many, many records, 50,000 records, 100,000 records, a million records as well, you're going to make use of batch apex, right? And batch apex is nothing but writing down a program in a particular format or in a particular way so that like no matter how many records on how many records you want to execute that particular program, Salesforce or Apex runtime engine automatically divides the batch, the records in the batches, the records on which you want to work into batches and execute that process into batches. So if you want to execute it on 100,000 records, then in that case, it will divide it into a batch of 2000 and it will create 50 batches of 2000 and it will execute it on first 2000 and then on second 2000 and then on third 2000. And this way, the execution will happen in batches. Right, in chunks. So if I'll give you 25 chapatis and a big bowl of dal to eat, you cannot eat it at once. But if I'll give you two chapatis at a time and a bowl of dal, you can eat it at that time. And when you're done with that, then if I'll provide you again, you can eat it at that time. You cannot do all of the things at once. So what you do is you divide it into batches or you divide it into chunks. That's what it is. You cannot eat a complete chapati at one time, right? You divide it into pieces. That's exactly what happens when you've got these many records. You divide it into parts. You divide it into batches. You divide it into chunks. And you execute that operation or you execute that particular code on each chunk. Is it clear? Okay, so that's exactly what a job of batch apex is. And batch apex is nothing but writing down your program in a particular way or in a particular fashion so that it automatically creates the batches or it automatically creates the chunks and execute that particular code which you want to execute on that particular on those records. Is it clear? Okay, let's have a look. So what I want to do is I want to update the lead records, right? I mean, I don't know how many lead records I've got in this particular role, but I want to update all of them. All of them. So how I'm going to write down the program? So let's have a look. Okay, so this might seem a little complex, but I'll bifurcate this program and explain it to you that what exactly we're doing over here. So in order to write down batch apex, you first need to create a batch class. What do you need to create? A batch class, right? And let's say how do we create a batch class? Give me a moment. So in order to create a batch class, what you have to do is you have to create a class. Keep the name whatever you would like to, right? Whatever the name that you want to give to this particular class, give it. But make sure that this class is global. Batch classes should always be global. It cannot be public, right? And I'm going to explain. Have I ever explained you the difference between public, private, and global access modifiers? I think we skipped that topic. I'm going to explain it to you right now. But after this batch apex, make sure to remind me that I need to explain the access modifiers, right? But meanwhile, just understand that it is global. Okay. Then comes lead update batch. Yeah, this is the name of the class. Now, in order to make this class as batch class, what do we need to do? We need to implement an interface. There is an interface called as database.batchable. Right? This is an interface. And we need to implement this interface into that particular class so that this class will be considered as a batch class. Is it clear? Everyone? Okay. So whenever you want to create a batch class, just create a global class and implement database.batchable and inside it, just provide S object, right? So let's see, like in this program, if I'm gonna write down implements database.batchable, batchable as object. So there is an error coming up. See, let's have a look at what this error is. Lead update batch must implement the method system.iterable database.batchable start. Can you see this? Right? It must implement the method execute. It must implement the method finish. So listen to this very carefully. Every batch class needs to have these three methods. Which three? Start, execute, and finish. Right? And why it is giving an error? Because these methods are declared in this interface. And you always have to override the methods which are declared onto the interface or inside the interface, or you have to define the methods which are declared in the interface. That's what it is, right? So in this class, until unless I write down the start method, the execute method, and the finish method, this class will not compile, right? So let me write it down. Database.query locator start. So start method is done. Let's try to save it once again. So see, there are only two errors now. Similarly, I'll have to create execute method. Okay, so now the problem is coming up because there is no return statement in here. Right? Let me write down return null. I think it will work. This is saved. So these are the three methods that you have to define in this batch apex class. Now let's identify the significance or the importance of each one of these methods, right? Start method. So inside the start method, you write down the code. Or you basically fetch the records on which you want to execute a particular operation. Listen to this once again. Inside start method, you write down or you fetch the records on which you want to execute the particular operation. So if you want to execute the operation on 100,000 lead records or 500,000 lead records or 1 million lead records, then the query that you write, that you'll write down to fetch all of those 1 million records or 100,000 records, is going to be written inside the start method, right? This is where you fetch the records on which you want to execute a particular operation, right? Then comes execute. In execute method, what are you going to do? You're going to write down the code. You're going to write down the code which needs to be executed onto each of those records, right? So if you want to update a rating field onto the lead, you want to make the rating as hot, right, for all of those records. So the operation that will happen to update all of those records will happen in the execute method. So the main code that you want to write down in that batch apex, or the code that you want to be executed on those records, will be written inside execute method. Is it clear? Next, finish. So after the execute method is done, after the execute method is done, or after performing that operation onto those records, when every batch and every chunk is done, if you want to do any post-processing thing, if you want to send an email, if you want to send a confirmation email that this batch apex has been executed successfully, this is what happened, this is what happened. And in that case, whatever code you want to write down, you can write down inside the finish method. Is it clear? Now listen to this very carefully. This start method executes only once. This finish method also executes only once. But this execute method executes like equal to the number of the batches that are created, or equal to the number of the chunks that are created. Is it clear? Right? So if there are 50 chunks that got created, then in that case, this execute method will be called 50 times. And why 50 times? Because it will execute that same operation onto those 50 records or onto those 50 chunks. That's what it is. Is it clear? Okay, let's go back to lead update batch. So start method collects the records or objects to pass to the interface method execute. That's what it does. This is the first method which is called when we execute a batch apex. It returns a database.query locator object that contains the records passed to the job, right? We call it batch apex, we call it batch job, we call it batch class. There's no difference between all of it. Like until unless there is batch attached, it always means that you're doing a particular operation or you're executing a particular operation in batches. That's what it is, right? So global database.query locator, right? Database.query locator is what? It's a return type, right? And in here you have written down start method, and inside it you have passed a parameter database.batchable context, and then return database.getQuery locator, and inside it you have passed a query select annual revenue from lead, right? This is the code that you have written down. Let's have a look at what is the annual revenue right now for the lead. Annual revenue is this much, right? Let's make it 2 million for each and every record, right? So over here in this method, I have written down this query. This query query will return me the records on which I want to execute a particular operation. And I need to make a database.query locator object in order for it to be returned in batches or in chunks. And then after this will get executed, it will pass the chunks to this execute method. And in this execute method, this lead list that we have created is going to get those chunks, right? So if there are, let's say, 10,000 records and we have created chunks of 2,000. So there are 5 chunks that will be created. So the initial 2,000 will be passed to list when we'll execute this execute method first. And then the next 2,000 will be again passed to list. And then the next 2,000 will again be passed to this list. That's how it's going to be. And inside it, what? Yeah, internally, with the help of this database.getQuery locator. Right. And I mean, after I'll get this particular list, I'll execute it in this way. If is equals to null, let me remove this one. I want to make the annual revenue 2 million for everyone. Right, and I want to update that record. So this is the main operation that I'm doing, and this execute method will be called how many times? Depending on the number of chunks or depending on the number of batches, right? Use the execute method to do the required processing of each chunk of data. This method is called for each batch or chunk of the record that you pass through, right? So that's what I've done. Let me make this 2 million and save it. Is it 2 million or like 200,000? 2 million, right? I've done this. And then let's talk about finish method. This method is called after all batches are processed. Generally, we write code inside it to send a confirmation email or execute any post-processing operation. Global finish database of batchable context. And over here, I've written down a program. Just a second. So I've written down the code which will send an email. So like whose email is working right now? Is there anyone whose email is working? Jojo's, Ayush, Kandelwal 2709@gmail.com. Anyone else? Yeah, so this is what it is. Aishk Nilwal and this. So over here, let's have a look at like how with the help of code you can send an email. I'm gonna give you the time to write down this particular code, don't worry. But let's have a look. Messaging.single email message. So I want to send an email. So I first need to create an object of this messaging.single email message class. And then what I have to do is I have created a list of string inside which I have got the email IDs of the recipients, right? To whom I want to send those emails. I've got the email ID for them. And in this object, mail set to addresses, I've written down, I passed this particular string or this particular list of string. So the recipients will be set as Ayush Khandelwal as well as Kilavaji, right? And then I've set the subject, set subject batch job completed. And then the plain text body, hey, the batch job that you started is successfully completed. And with the help of send email method, I've passed this particular list of the email message that I have to send, passing this particular object, and the email will be sent after that. That's what it is. So this is the process, this is the code that you have to write down to send an email using code. Anyways, currently our focus is on writing down the batch apex, right? Writing down the batch class. So in the batch class, first of all, we need to create a class which needs to be global, and it should implement database.batchable interface. And after that, which all methods we need to override or which we need to define. Start, what it does, it fetches all the records, right, on which we want to do that processing. Execute, it executes the operation that you want to perform, or it does the operation that you want to perform onto the records which we are getting with the start method. How many times start gets executed? Only one time, and that's the first method which gets executed, right? Whenever we initiate a batch apex class. And next, execute, and execute how many times it gets executed? Depending on the number of chunks, right? The next last is finish. We have to override finish method as well. And in finish method, you can do whatever you want to do as a post-processing part, right? When the updates are done or when the records are processed. Number of chunks. Yeah, number of chunks will be where we will give the batch size. I'm gonna explain it to you when I'm gonna explain you how to execute a batch apex. Wait for it. Okay. So is it clear with everyone? This complete batch apex class. Now I want to execute this class. How I'm gonna do that? Yeah, so this is an apex class and we want to execute it. How to execute it? Just call the start method, lead update batch. Tell me, what do I have to write down? This is another apex class. Consider it as another apex class. So I have to execute that main apex class and I'm going to execute that method. But what I'm going to write down in that method? Have a look. First, create the object of that batch apex class, right? Number one thing is that number one thing that you have to do is create an object of that batch apex class, and then make use of database.execute batch method and pass this object. Is it clear? That's all what you have to do. That's exactly what you have to do in order to execute a batch. I'm going to give you the time to write it down. Write it down all. But first, make sure to understand it in the appropriate way. Is it clear? And execute it. Executed. Go over here. Refresh this. It didn't got executed successfully. Oh, it got executed successfully. You got the email? Check your emails, guys. It's 2 million. Got the email? Perfect. So that's how you need to execute a batch apex class. Now let's answer the Shubhendu's question. You can also execute a batch apex by providing the batch size. And let me tell you what a batch size is. So you can pass a number which defines that how many records should be there in a particular batch, right? And how you can do that, there is another like method overloaded for database to execute batch, in which as a second parameter you can pass the batch size. So if I'll write down LUB 200, now the batch will be created for 200 records. Each batch will be created for 200 records. That's what it is. So over here you can provide the batch size. Is it clear, everyone? It's like, I mean, it will, okay. So batch apex is written over here so that you never exceed your governor limits. Whenever you want to do a particular processing that can exceed your governor limits, that's the only reason we have written down batch apex, because it divides the process into chunks. And the batch size is what you give, because, okay. So imagine there are like these records and you've divided it into batches. So like if there are 100,000 records and you have said that, or let's say 1,000 records, and you have said that I want to divide it into a chunk of 1,000 records each, right? So in that case, it will try to execute on that those 1,000 records. It will try to execute onto the next 1,000 records. It will try to execute it on the next 1,000 records until unless the 10,000 records or the whole 10,000 records gets executed. But if there is a problem with any of the record onto the third batch, all of the processing will be rolled back, because you're using a DML statement over here. If you would have used database.insert or database class method to insert it with a false attribute for all or none, and in that case, this problem wouldn't have happened. So that's the reason people try to keep the batch size as low as possible, or sometimes as high as possible, depending on what their requirement is. Same question? Okay. Anyone else? Any other question? Default batch size is, I guess, 200 or 2000. 2000 it is. It's written in the notes that I'm going to provide it to you. That's what it was. Now, using trigger. Using trigger? What? Yeah. No. What's the name of method in which batch size is passed? It's execute batch. Database classes static method execute batch. But governor limit is 150 for query. 150 for query. Like, so it's like 150 SQL queries can be there inside a particular code. So, I mean, yeah, what's the problem with that? We are not writing down any SQL query in this execute method. See, are we? Okay. Is it clear with everyone? Everyone? Okay.